Hi, I'm here at Sinclair Library. This is the desk that I use to upload most of my YouTube videos in the past couple weeks on Wi-Fi. And there's a handy outlet right here because my computer didn't have a battery. But I'm turning that laptop back in. Because I got a much nicer one, and I'm able to upload to YouTube at home, and I can also use the laptop in class because it's got a battery. So I'm really excited. So here we are. This is Sinclair Library, the older library of the two on UH's campus. The shelves aren't air conditioned. It kind of smells musty and dusty. It's not near as nice as the newer library, Hamilton, on the other end of the campus. But this is still a nice library. This is the one I come to most often because it's closest to the bus stop. Here's a replica of the Rosetta Stone. That's kind of inspirational. This is the computer lab I usually use. Some old U.S. Saturday Evening Posts. Shell collection. Copy machine. This is probably where I did most of my reading. But these tables fill up fast. Sometimes there's no space available. But it's the first day of classes, so there's plenty of room right now. And they took away the table that used to have the daily paper on it. Let's go see who's still on campus on the first day of school. I usually get the student newspaper. I haven't shown this part of the campus yet, so that's why I wanted to take this route. The old-fashioned bulletin board. Always full of notices. This is Gartley Hall, where Maya had her class spring semester of 2015, after there were too many people to fit into the class she was originally scheduled to teach in Saunders. Crawford Hall. It's where Colleen's class was spring semester. This is one of the nicest parts of the campus, I think. This is Saunders Hall, where Matsunaga Resource Center is, and it's where Maya and Ann Smoke and Jose all have their offices. They sell breakfast burritos here. Mostly sociology and economics, I think. Did you see that? It was a, I always have trouble remembering their names. Ricky Tiki Tavi, what was he? Mongoose. Don't see them very often here. I don't think they'll be that visible during the semester. It must come out when there's not so many students. This is the Queen Liliuokalani Center for Student Services. This is where the SEED office is, and the Senior Citizen Visitor Program is operated out of the SEED office. Since this is the Queen Liliuokalani building, I imagine that's why they planted these crown flowers here. Those were her favorite lei flowers. And they're also the sole food source for the monarch butterfly in Hawaii. Full flower here. I don't see any chewed leaves, so, well, here's one little hole. I've yet to see any monarchs or any caterpillars or chrysalises. I've often seen the butterflies hovering around here. There's the campus mall. I've done a previous video of that. There's the art complex over there. And this is Miller Hall. This is the building I had my human rights course in. More of the art complex. It was in the auditorium here that I saw an event last February by, what's her name? Famous journalist. Frequent these days. This is Watanabe Hall. This is where Maya's current of course she's teaching that I investigated this morning. Leadership for Social Change. And this is also where I took a little short, wasn't quite a seminar, but it was a meeting where we learned from creative writing instructors about the November program for being able to create a novel in 1 month. I haven't heard whether it's available this year or not. Nomo Romo is the abbreviation. Carol was my teacher for the human rights class. Colleen taught the civil liberties course. This is the lecture hall that Brian taught his class in fall semester last year. this is the post building. Pacific Ocean Science and Technology, I think it's the abbreviation of. This is where Hope Jaron used to run the lab that had the explosion last March 17th, I believe it was. And it's also the building where I made a videotape of Cynthia, May, Noor, and Angela Davis. That was just 3 weeks after the explosion. They still don't know what caused it exactly. They weren't able to recreate it at a testing lab in California. Boy, not many people still on campus. At least not in this part. About 5:30, so most everybody's already gone home for the day. This is the building complex that I took a workshop, one day workshop with Elizabeth Kent. Except I showed up about 45 minutes late because I couldn't find it. The map was a little ambiguous, online map. And so I picked that building. I thought it was that building it was in. I had to hunt around for it. And finally I went back to the library and looked it up again. Was finally able to locate it. But she was very gracious about it. She didn't get on my case about being so late. In fact, she was really impressed that I had done some research and learned about the time, long time ago, about 18 years ago or so, when her husband and she discovered a message in a bottle, believe it or not, written by a Russian sailor during the Cold War with a peace theme. This is the student center. That's a big workout area. For athletics, exercise. A nice mural.
Right.
took a seminar in there. Cafeteria. In the middle of the day, this place is just teeming with people. Bookstores downstairs. Let's see if they have any more copies of my book for tomorrow, but I'm not going to buy it. I just want to investigate. This is where we get student IDs. This place was packed the last time I got my ID here. Subway. Picked up a bunch of bus schedules there. And I think that's about all I have to show you right now, so I'll end it right here.